Alright, so today we will talk about the best settings to record some videos with the Canon EOS R. Intro. Alright, so after using the Canon EOS R for a while, I thought let's actually talk about my favorite settings to record videos with the Canon EOS R and what I recommend to get the best footage out of this camera. So let's get started. So if you're just starting out, the first thing that you need to set up is the frame rate, and here it's all about what you want to shoot. But first let's talk about simple 1080p recordings, and then we will talk about slow motion. To set up the FPS for a video like this one here, you'll need to decide between 24 frames per second and 30 frames per second. And yeah, in this case it's all about your own preferences. The most used one is 24 frames per second because it seems to be the most cinematic option, but some people like to use 30 FPS instead. So what I recommend is to check out both settings to see what you like the most. But today we will use 24 frames per second, and here we will use All Eye. This gives you the most data to work with your footage in your editing software. Next we need to set up the shutter speed, and here's the basic rule, always double your frame rate. So in this case it's 48, but we don't have the settings, so instead we will use 50 because it's the closest option. And now we have already set up the frame rate and the shutter speed, but now let's talk about the aperture. And the aperture is an option to decide how much light you let into the camera and how much is in focus or not. What I really like to use is a blurry background, so in most cases I have an aperture of around 2.8. But if you want to have more and more in focus, you need to use a higher aperture. So simply give all kind of settings a try to see what you like the most and what is working for you. But just to mention it here again, if you're using a higher f-stop number, your image will get darker and darker. So in the end this can lead to some problems if you don't have enough light in your studio, but we will talk about that next. And the last step is to set up the ISO. And here it's all about avoiding high ISO settings, because if you use too much ISO, you will get noisy footage. So before I push the ISO too high, I always try to add some more lights to make it easier for my camera to record the video. So now we have set up the frame rate, the shutter speed, the aperture and the ISO for talking head styles like this one here. But now let's talk about slow motion footage. And here you need to switch the frame rates to 60 FPS in All Eye. That's the only option Canon gives us in full HD. So that's why we need to use it. And of course we need to adjust the shutter speed too, so here we'll double that and go up to 1/25 because there's no 1/20 option. And the rest, like aperture and ISO, is again fully up to your own preferences and what kind of content you want to record. So these are the basic settings if you want to record some videos, but now let's talk about some color options. And here I'm using C-Log. That's a flat picture profile that allows me to get more out of the footage with my own color corrections. Most of these settings are set up to basic except of the sharpness, because I don't like the missing sharpness in the basic C-Log footage. So currently I add 3 stops to sharpness, but here I recommend to record some test footage that includes all the sharpness levels to find the best settings that fits your own style. Next let's talk about recording audio, and if you want to record the audio with some external microphones like the Rode VideoMic Pro Plus, I recommend to turn the audio level down. So what I always recommend is to keep the audio level low, because you can always make it louder in the editing, but if your basic recorded audio sounds bad or clips, you can't fix that in most cases. So basically that's what you need to know about recording audio. But now let's talk about the autofocus. And here I'm using the eye autofocus for sessions like this one here, because the eye autofocus is just awesome and you don't have to worry about your footage isn't in focus. But as soon as I don't record people or animals, I switch to the single dot focus, because here I have more control, or I use the manual focus to have full control. But in most cases, if I can't use the eye autofocus, the single dot focus is the way to go. And basically that's everything you need to know about recording stuff with the Canon EOS R if you want to get started. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you new year, don't forget to smash that subscribe button to stay updated for upcoming videos, and I see you in the next video.